What's up, little bros? VPB Money Man is here. Big bro's back. Feeling better back at work. I want to show you something on an example of what ruined dating, what ruined finances, and what ruined the common bond between the man and woman.
I'm going to show you an example. Now, this could be scripted. This could be made up. But women really act like this. Even though this could be scripted, which I think it is, women really act like this, and this is why you should stay away from these type of women. Check it out.
Damn, how you doing? What's your name?
Busy.
Busy? I ain't gonna lie, I like your hair. It looks really nice.
Thanks, I know.
Why you looking at me like that? I just want to talk to you real fast.
Don't you have like a job to do or something?
So why you insulting me like that instead of just like hearing me out?
I just think you kind of need a reality check.
Can I get your number before you go?
I gave you my Instagram, not my number.
My name Kilo. How can you be an asset to me?
I got all the assets.
Assets? You know how to make it clap?
Yeah.
Like the actual sound?
Yeah.
How can you be an asset to me? And the first thing she refers to is her body. Okay, when your body goes, what else do you have?
Can I record it?
Yeah, I guess if you want to.
For sure.
If you go, you know.
Tip you?
You did a lot of tipping, I guess.
For sure, let me see. Let me hear, actually. Oh, God. They're crazy. Clappers, them real clappers. I like that.
Your house look like your car or what?
My house bigger.
Oh.
My house is better.
Yeah, we can definitely.
Does your house look like your car? See, women really will look at this and think they can act like this. In my opinion, she ain't even that pretty, bro. She's not even that cute.
Do you see what happened in society? Women think that they're above the working man. My man is in a vest. He has a leaf blower. I don't know what he's doing. I'm sure that's scripted, like I said. But do you see how she said he needs a reality check? Why does he need a reality check? Why? Because he's working? Now, even though that's scripted, women will look at that and they will say to themselves, you know what? I only want to date a man with a nice car who has a big house. And a lot of men, a lot of young men, they don't understand the smoke and mirrors yet. You see, I'm 42. I've seen a lot, I've dated a lot, and I've seen a lot of stuff out here that is, it's not what it really is cracked up to be. This is why when young men hop in my comment section, I pay no attention to it because I know your little nuts didn't even drop yet. Your little marbles ain't even dropped. You know what I'm saying? Like, you still have not met that woman who's going to hose you out of your money. She's going to hose you out of your child support. She's going to get you for alimony. And then you will take chances with your money and you will follow people like this.
30-minute phone call full of value, full of gems. So let's go ahead and take a look at it, see exactly what's going on, get you guys in and out of here. So we got 3 stocks with short squeeze potential coming up.
I'm just here getting facts, but you be the judge. One that I'm looking at is called Cardano, ticker symbol ADA.
Paper Chaser, the only way, made $500 from a 7-cent penny stock. Tell me where else you could make that kind of money.
Tends to happen. Young men will follow people like that trying to get the quick money, trying to buy the nice car, trying to get that gold digging chick like that. In reality, you don't want a woman like that. See, let me explain how social media has ruined dating and has ruined it for the man. What happened, and it actually ruined it for women too. What happened was you had a lot of women that were small town girls. They grew up in these small towns and they, you know, they could only date the small town guy or the next town over. What happened was social media popped up and you'll have a girl, say, from Wyoming. Now you get a guy who likes her pictures in Florida, who's willing to fly her to Florida because she a little thick or she's a little cute. And now he gassed her head up. And now the hardworking guy in her town who has the blue collar job, he's the cop or he's the fireman. She fell for the guy with the fake pictures on Instagram where he's a rapper, he's a ball player, or he's fake rich living off of credit. And in reality, he's broke as hell, but she wants that guy. Now she gets pregnant by that guy who's a piece of crap. You know, he's partying with her in Miami. He's got her pregnant. He's got other girls pregnant. Then she comes back to the small town. She's severely overweight. She let herself go. And guess what? Now she wants that small town guy with the good benefits. He's got a pension. He's got an annuity. And then he settles down with her. And then guess what? She takes advantage of him and takes him for everything. Social media has ruined it for so many people. This is why I try to tell a lot of men, take your time when it comes to dating. Really take your time. Don't go out on a date and ask a bunch of questions. What can you do for me? What do you bring to the table? Because a lot of these women are slick now. They're watching a lot of these red pill channels and they're listening to a lot of their friends. You got to watch a woman's actions. Don't just look at what she's doing on the first, second date. Really watch her actions. Really watch what type of woman she is and ask a bunch of questions. Ask about her previous relationships. Ask about her ex-boyfriend. So many women want to throw dirt on the ex-boyfriend, but they pick them. Meaning, Future has how many baby mamas, and women keep sleeping with him without protection. Nick Cannon has how many baby mamas, and women keep sleeping with him without protection. How many ball players have multiple different baby mamas, and women keep thinking that they can change these men, or they're going to get a meal ticket from them. Really take your time and really ask a lot of questions. A lot of men fall into that thing where they start asking questions, and then women are good. They'll divert it back to yourself and say, well, tell me about you. Don't talk about yourself. If you're successful, don't be so quick to brag about yourself. Go, well, but brush it to the side. And then trying to reverse it, hit them with the reverse card and find out about them. You want to ask as many questions as you can, because remember something, even if they say their four last ex-boyfriends weren't crap, they picked them and they stayed there and they couldn't change them. So their decisions is what landed them with them. And if they have kids with those men, just remember something, those men were not crap and they still chose to have unprotected sex with them and have babies with them. I hope this video helps. Don't get yourself in trouble out there, men. Take your time. Don't fall for the social media glitz and glamour. It's not what you think it is, because the real world is the real world is harsh. It will chew you up and spit you out. No regrets. Get it.